surprised to see me again? I'm surprised too. Disney just released a teaser trailer for their new animated movie, Luca, which I think is supposed to be about a boy on vacation meeting another boy, but he secretly, like, not the Loch Ness Monster, but something of that sort. So I have to watch it because I liked Onward. I loved Onward and I liked Soul. So I'm looking forward to seeing what they're doing next. So let's dive into it. Let me pull it up so you can see this. All right. Here we go. Oh, it's Pixar. Okay. Okay, here we go. I'm excited. Oh my God, it's gorgeous. Oh my God. It's so beautiful already. Oh my God. Sorry. Oh, he's so cute. I love his voice. I love this music. Aww. They're having fun.
But there's just one thing. Whoa, wait. Did you see that?
No one can find out.
Oh. They're both monsters? Whoa. Oh.
Where did you boys say you were from?
Ooh, that's the summer. This is so cool. This is gonna be fun. This is very Aquaman. And I know Warner Brothers and Disney are always like butting heads. You know, Kevin Feige, even Feige, I need to say it correctly, but it's a weird name to say. Sorry, Kev. But Feige, who's the head of the MCU, admitted that he made Civil War because he heard about Batman v Superman. He initially didn't want to greenlight it, but then when he heard all the hype for BVS, he was like, let's do Civil War. And Civil War did a lot better than Batman v Superman. So, okay, let's go through this. This is so different than I thought it was. I only thought one of them was going to be monster-y. Oh, look at this. This is, it's gorgeous. Like, I knew this was going to take place in the Mediterranean. But holy cow, look at these hills, look at the green. Is this like Monte Carlo? Oof. This is gorgeous. Look at the water. This is gonna be fun. Oh, look at this. Oh, it's Elena. Cool. I wonder if that's a reference to anyone. This is, look at this, look at the buildings. It's so bright and colorful. I'm also really excited. This is the bar, Pita Luga. I don't know, I'm guessing this is Italian more than Spanish. I can't really place the accent. And then this guy looks straight up Scottish. I love the diversity and the characters. Look at this kid's face. Look at this kid's face. He just, this one squish the cheeks, boop the nose, ruffle his hair. He's just like the pinnacle of like, oh my God, adorable. Like, if anything happens to this child, I'm screwed. I'm just gonna be bawling my eyes out. Hey, lucky number 13. So this is his first time coming here. And I guess the redhead we meet later is a resident. What does this sign mean? No flowers allowed? I don't know that's what that's trying to say. Oh, this gets cute. That haircut though. So I love how Amaze he is. just by like people watching, because that's really fun to do. Is entrata, circle, pescata. It's like a fish store or a bar. Look at the sky. Oh, look at the sun peeking through. Sorry, I'm going frame by frame. It's so pretty. Look at the stuff on the walls, this color, like it just, there's like sun damage and you could just, it looks so lived in. I'm so excited. Oh, look how happy he is. Where are your shoes, sweetheart? I don't know if it's just because like him becoming a human. I don't know whether he was a monster first or he's cursed or something. They'll go into that in like maybe another trailer. But his feet look a little weird. I don't know if it's just the style, because his hands are pretty big too. I mean, this is a lot more cartoony or less. I wouldn't say Coco is very realistic, but I feel like the proportions looked more quote unquote realistic, and his hands and feet are really big. But maybe that's just also part of like he's blending in, so maybe it's weird. Look at them eating watermelon. This girl's so cute. Though she reminds me of like Pippi Longstockings or the Wendy's girl from like the Wendy's restaurant, fast food. She's really cute. I love the texture on her hat. It looks like knitted, which is so cool. Look at all these textures. And so I'm guessing are they brothers? Are they friends? Because they don't look super alike, and he has green eyes. And like their faces are different. It looks like they not stole these clothes, but maybe found them and was like, all right, we need to blend in. But I like that she's like, we're gonna be best friends. She reminds me also a lot of the movie Up, and the main, I forget his name, but the grandpa's wife when they were younger. She was very like outgoing and adventurous, and she seems very much in the same, like cut from the same cloth. I love how excited they are. This is gorgeous. Look at the lighting and the sky. This reminds me a lot of Tangled too, when they're at night about to see the lanterns by the castle. This is just same vibe, same colors. It's beautiful. I wonder what they're doing, where they're going. I love how mystical this feels. I wonder why it was just the two of them, though. From the creators of Coco. Oh, look at this little tuft. It's almost like a fin, which is cool because he's fishy. Oh, see, because here he has like a woven skirt that he made, but he has a shirt. Oh, this is so cute. Look how happy they are. I love the grass. The grass here also looks, oh my god, the stones here, that must have been so hard to just render or just get every little detail, like the water. Look at the water movement. Look at this grass. Look at how it interacts with them. It looks so good. Look how happy they are. Is that Let Universo? Is this French? Is this Italian? I'm guessing it's more, it's not Spanish. I think it's Italian. Look how happy they are. Oh, look how goofy. I love this. This is also going to probably bring me to tears. I loved how bouncy his hair was. Just because it's so much like Onward, where the relationship was about the brothers and it was really compelling because of those two characters. I don't know who's voicing these two, but I'm excited. Because what really brought the joy from watching Ian and Barley in Onward was the voice acting. Also their designs too, but I think Chris Pratt and Tom Holland did such an amazing job. And I have no worries that they're going to do a great job too. And also they're younger. I think there's going to be a lot of life. But I'm so excited. And look how dorky they are. They're like, this is how you dance, right? Oh, it's just, I'm so excited. Look at them. He seems like the... Like, I can see the dynamic already. Like, he's the risk taker, the one who leads. And he's like, I'm going to take you under my wing and we're going to go on an adventure. adventures. And he's like, really? I've always wanted to go on an adventure, but I never knew how. And it's just sweet. I hope that there's not like a love triangle thing going on. I hope I have like PTSD from watching Fate, the Winx Saga, and the Vampire Diaries recently. But I think it's about just them being friends. But I think there is going to be something where he's going to want to stay around more to hang out with the girl. He's going to get upset. I hope they play it out in a more interesting manner because, you know, that seems predictable. But I'm excited to see these two grow. Look how expressive they are. Look at that mouth. Ooh. That's almost like Hubert level expression. Why doesn't he have a helmet? Look at this. Oh, God, and everything's breaking. I almost thought time was slowing down here. Wow. Uh-oh. Wah. Oh, thank God they didn't land on the rock. Look at their designs. Look at the, like, the fins that are more hair. And I love his design. I love both of their designs, but his color scheme reminds me a lot of when Joe Gardner in Soul passed on. He was very, like, minty green and blue, so it's interesting. It's a similar color scheme. Also, it blends in more with the water. He looks more like a deeper ocean dweller because of his darker fins. That's just my opinion. But oh god, this is so cool. And I love how you can still see their human aspects in their fish form. This looks so cool. And look at the way the water reacts to him jumping in. We gotta go. Oh, he's gonna ruin it. He's gonna be a weirdo. I hope the sun's cool and he's just like, I just wanna make friends. Maybe that's his, I think it's his sun. Look at the, oh, look at the way there's like, I can't tell if they're like sparkly or if that's like the water on them, but that's beautiful. I love this. This is a great little freeze frame. Cause look at, it's like, they're like little pearls of water. It looks so great. I'm guessing these guys are going to play a role too. Maybe they're hunting for them. There's like a legend about them. Yeah, because it seems to be like they're mythical and this is what we've done in the past. It's like a celebration of like we've killed fish and obviously they live on like the water. They're probably a port where it's like the market is fish. So it makes sense like this is what they do, but it's a little scary. I mean, look at this. This is such a cool pose. I wonder if we'll learn about his history and like maybe he's the descendant of someone in the town. I feel like it would be a missed opportunity. I wish I could see more of these posters. I'd love to see what they're about and what they're referencing. Oh, this town is so beautiful and cool. Like I was just looking at like these, the electricity running and I'd love to see this town, like this area at night. I know we saw the rooftops at night, but I want to see this. What are you looking at? Oh, is that gelato? Oh, I want ice cream. That looks so good. I hope that's matcha or pistachio. Maybe that's just vanilla. It could be coconut. Mm. Ooh, look at the way he moves. It's amazing how quickly he transformed back into a human. Like it reminds me a little bit of H2O, but in H2O it was kind of the reverse. If they had one droplet of water touch them, they would turn into a mermaid. If you guys don't know that show, it was an Australian live action series about girls turning into mermaids and it was a lot of fun. Recommend. It was on Nickelodeon and I think this is kind of cool, but it was always hard for them to transform back. They'd have to be completely dry before they can undo their mermaid transformation, which was always a point of contention because they had to like make sure that like they didn't get found out. But it's amazing how quickly like he takes like one breath outside the water and he's able to be human. I love the way they swim. Look at the way they dive. They're having so much fun. I love the life and hope in this guy's eye. I don't know their names, but I love them. I wonder why it's called Luca. I don't know if it's because we're following that specific boy and his name is Luca, or is Luca means like ocean? I don't know Italian, I'm sorry. But I'm excited about this. Oh, what a shot. And he's just like, oh boy. Oh, he has a tattoo. That looks like the same serpent that other guy was holding here. It's a different, he has a harpoon and this guy has a trident on his arm. But it looks like the same sort of serpent creature. I love this. I love that only half of him turns. That's really cool. And I love seeing the contrast in them. I like that he still has like a nose. Or not really. I guess it's still bulbous on this side because it's not all the way wet. But it flattens. I love that he tackles him and she's like, eh? Nothing. Oh, that's the harpoon. Oh, okay. I didn't see that. But that's the harpoon that this guy uses. So I'm guessing this guy is an ancestor of the guy that killed like the big serpent over here. So that's going to be a point of contention. He's going to be very proud. Oh, he even looks like he has a map of like where things, like where there's been sightings. Oh, of course, it's a dead relative. I'm guessing that's her mom. That's just always how Disney is. They have to kill a parent. No one can have just a fully functional family. I love the tomatoes that they're growing. Oh, those are probably so juicy. I don't even like tomatoes that much by themselves, but those just look so plump. Really good for making a good marinara or pizza. Nothing. I like that there's so much in their expressions. I'm so excited. See, he looks so much like the guy. I love this cat. Look at that cat. Nothing. Oh, this looks fantastic. I can't wait. I can't believe. What do you mean this is not yet rated? It's probably PG. There's no blood. There's no cursing. It's Disney. It's PG. Let's be real. Maybe we'll get like one scene where like their lives are at risk because they are getting hunted and they are considered like hunting material or whatever. But oh, this looks so good. Oh, that looks beautiful. I love the colors. I hope you guys found that as exciting as I did. I like that, like, they didn't have to say much, but they told us, they gave us a lot with just the environment and, like, characters instead of just, like, the basic plot. But we were able to take away, like, they have to keep the secret. They meet a human friend. Shenanigans ensue. There's going to be tension when the dad figures out their Loch Ness-like. So I'm excited. That looks really good. I found that beautiful. I can't wait to see another more in-depth trailer because that was just technically a teaser. Even though that was a lengthy trailer. Let me see. That was almost a minute and a half. Usually teasers are a minute to like 45, 30 seconds at most. So that was hefty. So I'm guessing a real full-fledged trailer will be like 2 minutes, maybe? That's exciting. I wonder when that'll take place. I know Disney just had like a winter conference going over like moving some things around in terms of like the Marvel Disney Plus series and movies and stuff like that, and other things that they're planning that are not just Marvel related. Again, it's a Disney event, but Marvel obviously is taking place. There was a Star Wars, I think it's the Bad Bunch was mentioned to be released in May, because it's going to premiere on May the 4th because it's May the 4th be with you, and then it'll continue on May 7th. But that looks really exciting. What did you guys think? Let me know below. And if you want to subscribe to see more, please do. I'd love that. I hope you find these reactions interesting. They're just really easy to do. Not to like minimize what I'm doing. I've always wanted to like do reaction stuff because I find it really fun. And I watch a ton of it. It's my guilty pleasure. And I watch a lot of behind the trailer stuff with Grace Randolph, and I love her. So I've always wanted to do this. So I hope you guys found this enjoyable. Let me know what you thought, and I'll see you guys soon. More stuff to come. I have a project in the making. Not something huge, but I think like a continuous segment that isn't just reactions. I'll do some stuff, so stay tuned. And I promise. We're getting back to gaming. My carpet came yesterday, and my new bed's coming today. And then the only thing that will be left is a light fixture, but I just want my room to have my bed. I'm tired of being on the floor. So once I have my bed, we will get back to streaming and we'll get back to normal, or what was normal before, even though I started during the pandemic, which isn't normal, but whatever. You know what I mean? Anyway, I'll see you guys soon. Bye-bye. Have a good one.